Hey everyone, hello and welcome back. Tony Bing again here. For today's video, we'll be having a look at the Iron Man Mark II variant. Now, this was a second anniversary login reward. If you missed it, keep an eye out the next time the Civil War event rolls round. There is a Team Iron Man mystery box you can purchase from the store, and there's a chance that you can get a token for that particular variant there. So let's get called in and let's run through these skills. Now, the first one we're looking at is Micro Missiles. So it's physical damage, it fires 12 projectiles with a cooldown of 5 seconds, and tied into that you have bigger payload, so that will do a slight AoE kind of damage effect around each of the missiles. There it is there, quite nice looking, I like how they come out the back of his suit. Now next up we have Missile Salvo, so this fires 6 projectiles, 6 second cooldown. If we place fuel points into extended barrage, we've got another 6 projectiles being fired for 12 in total. Now, this is nice, if you use it in wide open areas, any missiles that miss the target will come back and home in. In this particular set of circumstances, the chances are most of the missiles will hit off the scenery, but it's actually a good example of how it can happen. If you're in a level which has got a lot of walls and so on, there's a good chance that some of this could be wasted. So we'll activate it so you can see what I'm meaning. There we go. Some of them came back, but you can see a portion of them kind of hurt the areas there as well. So the next skill we've got, we're now onto a beam one, moving on from the missiles, you've got channeled repulsors. So it's a set amount of energy damage twice per second, channel time 2.5 seconds and cooldown of 8. This looks pretty nice. There we go. Nice kind of typical Iron Man skill there. We now have defensive skill. We have force shield. So you take 10% less damage. Buff duration is 5 seconds with a cooldown of 15. If you put full points into it, it's up to 6.4 seconds. Now, that's pretty nice. 10% damage rating really can't be sniffed at, but it was previously 25%, and ever since that, it's kind of been brought down. I've kind of been a bit disappointed in this. 25% was maybe a bit too powerful, but 10 and only gaining an extra 1.4 seconds for 15 points doesn't seem like the best investment, but I've activated it so you can see it. There we go, it is there. And then next up, we're back to another beam power. We've got Repulsor Barrage. So energy damage, 10 hits, cooldown 10 seconds. There we go there. And then to finish up, we've got the one-off, which is just the same as the regular Iron Man model signature there. So it's energy damage, does 3 hits, does a not bad amount of damage, 153,000 without any gear maximum, so we'll activate it. And there we go, we can see the 3 separate damage packets there on it. So what I'll now do, put points into the setup I'd be using if I had them in active mode. We are by and large just putting most of our points into the hardest hitting skills here. There we go, that's the setup I'd be looking to use, and as mentioned, with force shield, because you're only gaining an extra 1.4 seconds with 15 points, I would much rather put my points in another place, and for only 1 point, you're still getting the 5 second buff, so 33% uptime on that shield, which is nice. So, passive wise, you've got Overwatch Protocol, this is pretty nice, it's 1 energy and 300 to ranged powers. So if you're on a ranged energy character, you're looking at doing an extra 460 damage rating, which is really not bad at all. Now, for his benefit while team up as away skills, you've got 2 of them here. You get micro missiles, bigger payload, which in turn converts into friendly fire, friendly skies even, and then you have force shield, which would then become remote defense. So I've had a few rotations of your skills, so let's reset that and put points into the setup I would use here. There we go, that's the setup I'd be looking to use. Now with that, you've got your 10% activation chance here. We do have max power going into micro missiles, which is the main damage skill. And although we didn't max force shield on our active build, I would max it on the passive one because there's not as many places for the points to go round, and I don't really see value in putting points into the small AoE or getting this chance higher. We put the full 15 points into remote defense because this is actually activation chance when you get hit, but the activation chance with full points goes up to a rather high 38%. So simple enough team up, especially if you've played Iron Man, a lot of the skills will be similar, but it's just the nature of having a team up that's also a hero in the game. You do get that sense of familiarity there. So once again, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you all again soon.